Okay, everyone, I have just gotten word. It is time. Get the hype going in the chat. Rayman Legends happening right now. Take it away.
LattMackey, thank you so much. Doing a great job as the host, as always, right here. And I'm Spikevegeta. This is Rayman Legends. I am one of a peanut gallery of commentators we have for you today. Again, I'm Spikevegeta. We can go down the road.
I'm DJTHED.
I'm Nils147.
And yeah, and the runner today is going to be DepressingChild. They're going to be focusing on the run all day. This is Rayman Legends, any percent. And I guess we can give a countdown. I guess I'll count
sure.
it down?
Sure,
yeah. Hey, we hadn't really thought about this, but sure. So, and then, yeah, we can start it on y'all's end, and we can start it on DepressingChild's end. It's one of the top any percent runners in the world. So let's get it going in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. All right. You could tell we all rehearsed, making sure that we were going to be, you know, we were going to be the live audience as well. But yeah, again, this is Rayman Legends. The last time this was actually shown at a GDQ, I had the pleasure of running it 4.5 years ago at AGDQ 2016. Kane, you were there as well. And I think you would agree with me, this game almost looks like night and day, the differences.
Absolutely.
To the
like, there's so much tech and movement, just optimizations that have been implemented and discovered, and there's a lot of new stuff even being found in like the past month.
They generated new
we definitely got to show for you, and it's going to be an exciting run.
I kid you not, DJ, who's in the call with us, has been messing around with routing in this game. Literally, as we were about to, as our mics were about to go hot for you all, we were going to be talking about, oh, what's a routing change that DepressingChild may or may not do in this run. The biggest thing that's going to be going on is the main objective of this game, obviously, get to the end of the game, get to the credits. There are 5 main worlds, and within each of those worlds, there's a boss at the end. In order to get to them, we have to collect the MacGuffin. In this game. The MacGuffins are these little blue happy guys, although they're not very happy right now. They're actually getting kind of tortured, captured, flung around. We need to save any 260 of those, and we can access all of the different bosses, the one at the end of each of the 5 worlds. So you're actually going to be seeing right here, this is level 1, but first up, DepressingChild is actually going to quit out right here. And he's going to swap over from Rayman, who you would have seen me play as 4.5 years ago. Now, with I call it the 2020 tech. Kane, you've been trying to get me to play as Glowbox for about 10 years
like
now.
The game's limited out for 7. Where?
Yeah. Tell me a little bit, Kane. You were the one who first wanted to come up with it. Why are we going to be playing as Glowbox?
Fundamentally, each of the characters have slightly different hitboxes and various other motions that differentiate themselves. And Glowbox has a really big hand in particular. And that hand's gonna allow him to kick through different walls and just kind of reach farther to make smaller time saves throughout the run. We'll definitely try and point them out as they go. It's not as clear as maybe you would like, but 3 seconds here, 5 seconds here. All you need to save is about 15 seconds and you make up for the character swapping.
DJ, you want to talk a little bit about either some of the tech or Murphy? There's a lot of stuff going on screen right now, including a clip.
Yeah, what we just saw there was a reset sequence. It's technically a death abuse. It allows you to spawn ahead of level because we trigger a checkpoint that's literally ahead of us. So we can just restart sequence and spawn ahead, and we get to keep the TNT that we collected earlier. So it's same stuff.
The actual YBY up there, you might be wondering if you played this game, how he's able to jump so high. We'll definitely go into more later, but there's a technique called a YBY, and there's a variation of it that acts as like a launching mechanism to send you up as well. But there we have it.
Yeah, there's two. Yeah. There's the first level already in the books. You see this game can go very, very fast. Within each of the levels, there are either 10 or 3 teensies that the runner will have access to. You see, for the most part, we're going to collect the 8 smaller ones you can see on the top of that painting right there. And then a handful of the king and queen teensies, 2 of those in each of the levels. They require fire going off in the side room, so they're generally not worth it. I believe the longest teensy in the game would be about 17 seconds to pick up, so pretty tight cut there to actually get in. Right into the 80% route. We're going to get some momentum right here going downhill. Gain a ton of speed going through all those enemies. I always like to say almost kind of like Donkey Kong Country style. Every time you want to do a spin, there's a cooldown time. But every time you spin through an enemy or an object, that refunds that ability to do a spin. So you can build up a ton of speed that way. Now we're going to have Globox use that hand to punch up, get that cage, and I have to use the slow pillow. Come on down. We're going to see a version of Globox also here. He's got that longer reach, so doesn't have to go all the way up to that platform, and then into the water we go.
Yeah, this game is a very momentum-based game where you see him use slopes or various other mechanisms to gain speed, and then you want to bounce in order to preserve that momentum as far as you can.
Health-wise, this game is based on you generally one hit and you'll die, but you can pick up hearts throughout the run. And those will allow you to have one bonus hit. Nice ground pound, a lot of momentum coming off of that slope right there. Immediate ground pound. Ground pounds are nice because they extend your hitbox vertically. And that can allow you to snap some things from above or connect into things from above, like those bumpers you'll be seeing throughout the game.
Oh, just got the silver.
Barely got too much. So in addition to the teensies, yeah, DJ, do you want to explain what the other collectibles are in the game?
Sometimes we want to get lums in some of the levels, and that'll give us lucky tickets if we get enough of them. But most of the time, we don't want to get too much, because that ends up wasting some time at the end of the level. As you see, during the count-up, it takes time to count up. So the less lums we get, the less time we waste. And if we can avoid getting the lum trophies, we also save more time, because the lum trophies take up even more time when we get them.
So snagging a heart during that load screen, that's going to be a reoccurring thing here on the PC version.
It's really the only way. So they're actually, most everybody in the community runs on PC, although I think current world record is actually on Xbox One. The nice thing about Xbox One and PS4 is that they have actually zero load times, effectively. You don't have those load screens where you can grab a heart, but because you don't, you can't utilize those load screen hearts for like damage boosts and whatnot. Another clip right here from Globox. That one can actually be done with any of the characters, but Globox can do it. Also gonna break through this vine right here just to snag that teensy from below. And don't blink, because this level is already
it's
over.
It's like tied with one of the fastest levels in the game. Are we doing 8% in terms of like teensies per minute?
Yeah, that final teensy, just in and out, you're done.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's almost one of those, if you don't run the game yourself, you might not know some things are teensies with how quickly we snag them. Like, we're going to do our best to try to point them out. Like, you didn't see it, but he got a teensy right there, including some that we're not even going to collect ourselves, because that would be too much work. So now we go into Ropes Course. So this is another level where we're going to have to utilize both Globox and Murphy, our little buddy right here, a little frog buddy. So originally this was a Wii U, it was going to be a Wii U exclusive game. And this little green fairy frog thing, Murphy, he was going to be actually real quick. Let's see if we get a lot of speed right here. Oh, we're keeping it all over the slope with the big jump. Let's go. And then holding out to get that boost, going through the water, and then diving out of it. Very nice off the dolphin dives. Yeah, I had to shut up for a second because that was really good. But yeah, this is originally going to be a Wii U exclusive. Murphy was going to be controlled with the gamepad, which he still is. But when they wanted to bring it to like PS3, Xbox 360, all these other consoles, they made it to where like, well, the player will just control both of them. So keep that in mind throughout this playthrough. There are a ton of levels where he's going to have to control both Globox and Murphy. And for a lot of other instances, a third character as well. And that's all being controlled with one controller. Yo, nice. Lots of nice little stalling out just to cut out any slow ledge grabs and whatnot. This is one of the first of the side rooms we're seeing. Nice double jump right there to extend his distance over to the Queen C, the Queen TC as we call it. Can be setting up for another break boost right here. Kane, do you want to explain again, like, what break boosts are exactly when we're going for
sure. Break boosts, so, maybe Fed's a little bit suited for the break boost. There's a...
Fed was actually the one who found it, I believe.
It's one of the more complicated techs in the game, and it doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. But essentially, what you do is you run in place for a bit, and you essentially build up a burnout meter. That's invisible, you can see it. You spin, which is a dash attack or whatever. You go fast when you do a dash attack. And then you let go of your direction. You don't use hold neutral on your analog stick or your D-pad. And when you exit your spin, you enter a break animation. And if you set up properly, you actually gain speed instead of losing speed when you break, which makes zero sense, but that's how it works.
But thank God it works that way.
It's somewhat intentional as far as I can tell, because like the burnout, like they actually had a name for it. The programmers.
I mean, burnout is an intentional mechanic, but the break force thing, more or less, might not be. It's hard to say. Like, it doesn't... Burnout is intentional. Break force, I don't know. It's hard to say.
All right, so coming into Quicksand, though, we're going to see the activation of a second player, I believe, or some co-op tech.
Yes, it's later in the level, right? We don't use it at the start.
You have to activate it beforehand, though, right? I don't know. We'll find out.
I do want to say, so we got my good friend LattMackey over reading donations for us. This is about to be mostly an auto-scroller, and we'll give you other opportunities to read donations just in between each of the levels. But until we get up to that point, Latt, if you want to just go ahead and start reading donations, we're just going to be scrolling auto-style.
Thank you, auto-scroller, and thank you, Spike, and everyone doing the commentary behind the mics there. Drift Peasants donates $50 and says, Doctors Without Borders is a worthy cause at any time, but especially now. Money goes to Runner's Choice. Also have a $100 donation from Kindle Jack that says, SGDQ is the hero 2020 needs. May the RNG be with you. And finally, a $500 anonymous donation puts us over $25,500. Thank you, everyone. Ooh. We are getting there.
That's awesome, guys. Despite this being online, all sorts of amazing runs and runners going on throughout the week. Actually, a lot of people internationally able to run who wouldn't be able to make the trips in the first place. So thank you, everyone, for your generosity. Let's keep it going all throughout the week, only here in Run 3. Excited to see Rayman Legends getting a really good time slot here for the marathon. This is an amazing speed game. Now, coming up, we have got what Kane was getting to, this two-player boost.
So we've got the player two active, spawned yet. There it spawned.
Yep.
You stand on it, you launch, and now you're at full speed.
Yeah. Normally, you have to wait for that tower to fall down, and you'll have to slowly climb that tower. But utilizing that co-op booster allows us to make that cycle before it falls down.
Yeah, and that is one of those. There's a ton of tech in Rayman Legends. That's one of the instances where, like Nils was saying, you would not be able to make that
otherwise.
Yeah,
it's impossible without two-player.
With any sort of break boost or anything. So also what was going on in that level worth pointing out, we're actually going to be doing in the next two levels as well. So we brought up the lums that you can collect throughout the level. Every time you breathe, you'll get lums. You beat an enemy, you get 5 lums. You save a teensy, you get 25 lums. The little skull tokens are worth 25, so on and so forth. For the most part, we want to avoid those. However, there are 10 levels throughout this run. Nice flop. Oh. There are 10 levels throughout this run where we want to be collecting enough lums in order to get the lucky tickets. And generally, those for the bigger levels are going to be collecting 450 lums. And just long in the tooth about it, those are going to allow us to gain access to other fast levels later on in the route in order to get us to that 260 goal count of teensies.
So on that Queensy there, we had a nice double jump, so... Might take a moment to explain what that is when you see it. So there's a tech called a YBY in this game.
Which you've gone over that yet,
you use way. All over the place, where it's just attack, and then you press attack and jump at the same time. And it's named after the Wii U inputs. And there's, I don't know, half a dozen variations on it at this point. where like the flop that Spike mentioned earlier is a version of the YBY where you press down. If you press up, you get a YBY up, which allows you to gain height. And during that YBY up, there's a way to set it up where you press jump again and you get a second jump. And that allows you to gain a lot of height.
Nice utilization of Glowbox's hand being so big when you do that little kick right there off the YBY that actually slaps through the armor of this enemy and is able to take him out. So you can see right there in the top left corner of the UI at 352 lums right now, snagging another 25 off grabbing that Teensy. You'll see sometimes we'll collect Teensy so fast, the UI in the top right can't quite keep up, and it'll just get queued up for a while. Drop it down, snag another Teensy right here. We're gonna be trying to set up for another break boost right here. Again, trying to get that burnout speed. They're very, very hard to do, very tight frame windows, but a lot of times you wanna know where to set them up to try to save frames and sometimes full seconds here and there. Kane, explain the name of this. I know you want to.
This is our first instance of Gandalf the Wizard, who grants us a magical fist power-up. That's actually his name, if you were wondering.
I can't believe that's real.
Yeah, it's actually, when you, we did a practice commentary of this, scripted, he was like, yeah, that's Gandalf. And I was like, haha, that's funny. You like Lord of the Rings. No, that's actually named Gandalf. I went, I did not know this lore. That is not the last piece of lore we will hear from Kane Apache during this commentary.
We were just chatting about lore in this game, and I found out that I'm the only person that knows the lore in the game, so time to get the word out.
We'll be discussing more about that later, I'm sure.
Yep.
So here we are. Again, there are the five main worlds in the main campaign of this. There's more levels and other spots that we'll actually gain access to. But again, we need to beat the boss of each of them, and this is the first one. Right here, he's going to restart sequence as soon as he kills these enemies, because it's actually going to warp us to the end of this cutscene where the dragon slowly raises up to the middle of the screen. Saves you a good, 4 seconds. You can do the same thing there if you kill the three enemies and then you take a death abuse. If you're really fast with your menuing, you can save some time, though. And the dragon's gonna come up. We're gonna get right up in his chin. And this is, believe it or not, 5 shots right here.
Bam! Looked like 3, but
that's a
trust us.
Yeah. It's a pretty fast mashing right there. And now, so that was the first phase. There are 3 total phases to this boss. We're going to effectively try to skip over the second phase right now.
Oh. Yeah, we got this.
Oh.
Let's try. Good job.
Oh, looking very good. Very nice. And able to get the team.
Normally, this phase is soft locked here if you do the skip, but if we utilize the restart sequence, we can get the dragon to come back.
Yeah, so another thing that was not present when I ran this game 4.5 years ago was there was nothing at all that could be considered a skip and a boss in the same sentence. Now there's a number of them throughout this run, actually, and that's one of the smaller ones.
Yeah, the only bosses we have so far that don't have skips is World 3 boss and World 5 boss. All the other ones have skips of some sort.
But the World 5 boss is interesting, so.
Yeah,
so it's fine. And World 3 has more, so it's cool. So with that, slapping the first of the dark Teensies into the moon. You got 4 other seats left up there. We need to send the 4 other nerds up. But as we're making our way to World 2 and getting our collectibles, Lat, if you want to go ahead and read us 2 or 3 more donations, that would be great.
Perfect timing. The Crank Machine donates $15 and says, I have a Teensy Weensy question. Is this what everyone's talking about when they say ray tracing? Call me a lum for Jack, because my puns are going to cut deep this GDQ. I'll be back with more soon. I think we look forward to them.
I'm looking forward to it. I'm hyped.
We have a $50 donation from Yannick106. Thank you so much for your $50. And we have a $25 donation from Hayes that says, been watching GDQ for years, and I'm grateful to be in a position to donate to a great cause. Good luck to all the runners this year, and stay safe, everyone.
All right, so this is a very windy level, and wind has a very cool effect on momentum of making friction really minimal. And so at the beginning there, he was able to use a co-op boost and a double jump in order to just sail through the whole opening of the level.
It was just a wide way up, no double jump.
Yeah, wind is very, very fun. All right. Now, in this sequence right here, you're supposed to utilize this soccer ball. However, DepressingChild is not a soccer fan. Get out of here, soccer ball. Effectively using that double jump right there, which is a variation, or I guess it's effectively it's the YBY up. I'm not as good with the tech
it's
in this game.
It's a continuation. Like, it's additional inputs past a YBY up, but yeah.
Okay. So we're going to utilize that big fist power right here. Barely snagged the bottom of that teensy right there. And some nice flying through the wind there, plus a damage boost utilizing that heart we got. And now doing a ground pound underneath that bumper down there that extends your hitbox vertically, allowing you to snap up into it and get a lot of height going upwards. Big boost here. Getting a lot of height. Snag one more teensy. Try to stay on the right side. If you hit the purple lum in this string of lums, then all the other lums are doubled. Obviously, we want to keep those lum counts low and the levels we don't want lucky tickets on. And skip out. Only have 252 or 277. Sorry, 25 more there.
Can probably fit a donation in.
Absolutely. We have a $25 donation from Jamato that says, I love watching GDQ every year. Thank you to everyone who has worked hard to make it happen this year. Thank you so much.
And thank you all once again for all the generosity. Going into 2-2, the Winds of Strangers is the next level. We're actually going to be collecting all 10 of the teensies. Utilize this bumper to get some good height. And bringing back in Murphy. Right here, Kane, I'm still giving you credit for finding this. The bone wall climb.
Did I find that?
Very nice. You told me about it, so I'm going to say you found it. Take the credit. Take the credit, idiot. My God.
It's so long ago. There's very few things in terms of strat-wise that I remember, other than like the free break boost coming up. It's like the only one that really stands out in my mind.
Mm-hmm. Nice, skipping out of that whole left section right there. You see lots of ground pounds and whatnot just to skip out on the utilization of a lot of those other bumpers.
Boost, all you have to do is squish yourself against the wall and you get it.
Yeah, I like to just call those bone wall boosts right there. And if you just, like Kane's saying, you squish yourself against the wall and then spin through it, you'll get a ton of speed coming out of it. Nice quick snag of the King C right there.
And then using Murphy here to boost yourself with the platforms, it's kind of less significant here, but it's definitely a feature you're gonna see more often is anytime there's an object that's moving, you can use Murphy to move it while you're attached to it to try and gain momentum off of it. Very nice.
Mods break boost.
I love that double bounce the chain. Very nice.
You'll be seeing a lot of that Murphy tech in 5-1 for sure, which is actually the next world, even though it's world 5.
Yeah, what's really interesting from a routing standpoint of this game is that all 5 worlds are available to you as soon as you have 65 teensies. So you can see right there, he just passed 65. Again, our goal is 260. So he can go to any of the 5 worlds he wants to at this point. We're going to utilize that to try to cut out as much overworld movement as we can, obviously. Into another nice windy level right here. Castle in the clouds. Snag that poor teensy just getting beat up.
I love the villains in this game, where it's just like, all right, you're the bad guy. Literally just stand there and punch this teensy into the ground.
This is what we're paying you for. And then right here, we're going to have a death abuse. We're going to slap this teensy, immediately ground pound, and that'll checkpoint us up top, and it'll let us keep the teensy.
Yeah, some nice stuff spawning right there. Spawning that player 2 right there also increases the speed of that respawn animation, so that's a cool little trick he threw in there.
Upcoming, we have one of the fastest teensy rims in the game.
Yeah, this King C, it's, if you don't walk into a room and they just explode like this, BAM! Then it's probably not fast enough to be in the route.
It's an amusingly slow room if you don't know what you're doing, though, because you're like sailing around in circles chasing it.
All right, coming up here, we got DepressingChild going for the big coyote jump. This is based on cycles all throughout the level. Let's see if he can make it in front of this vine. Ooh. Oh, we are hovering away.
All good.
I did this at GDQ as well. Yeah. Still going to be able to get a backup off of those parachutes and then keep this momentum going.
Oh, that's all right. Hover to the end.
Oh, oh. Yeah, nice recovery right there. The immediate snapping yourself up from the ledge and into the doorway. 9 more teensies in our pocket. Probably not in our pocket. It would get very uncomfortable in there. I love Glowbox's animations. For forever, I didn't want to play as Glowbox. So I was like, I don't know. He doesn't look as cool. He makes up for it in cute factor. He's swag.
If you're wondering, though, his hitbox in terms of something hitting him is the same size as Rayman's. So there's certainly times where you can just grind Glowbox's face through a spike wall or something. You know, the ceiling, and it's just like, yeah, that's not a hitbox. It doesn't matter.
Oh, time for another two-player boost, and
oh, it's all good.
Oh, with the damage boost, yep. Rounded and calculated.
Anyways, it doesn't matter.
A fun fact, on the Wii U version, you can skip those Murphy cutscenes by activating Murphy with a touchscreen early, but, you know, we don't run the Wii U version for pretty obvious reasons, but fun fact.
Another nice climb up the left side of the wall. I always feel like that barely
it
saves
does
any
barely
time.
Save any time.
Otherwise, you have to go up. You'd have to go all the way up through the chute and then back down to get to it.
Yeah, like, still, everything cool in this game, though, like in terms of strat-wise, like you're saving a second, half a second. Oh, this is a few frames faster. And it doesn't really, when you're actually trying to learn a level, like how to go fast, it's like you've got all these strats that you can add in that are pretty negligible. But it all adds up where, like, you save 47 individual seconds across the level. That's a lot of time.
Right.
Also,
ooh, nice recovery.
Also,
bear
with us if the stream starts lagging a little bit. Our runner is on satellite internet, so it can be a little inconsistent sometimes.
Nice cutting out some slow bumpers and whatnot. We have a heart right here. We want to go for a damage boost at the end of this level.
It didn't quite work out.
Nice.
Yo, nice. Yeah, so you can see after you take damage, you actually get, even though there's no real visual for it, you do get a little bit of grace period of effectively iframes. And you utilize that to have almost like a double bounce to skip out on all those slow bumpers at the end. Nice break boost. Nice thing about the load screens is you just get to practice your movement. You can warm up your hands.
So much tech in this game was found in the load screen. No memes. Just people bored, like mashing buttons. Like, oh, that's not the result I expected.
Another very fun. Anything with wind in this game, very, very fun because it's so easy to keep so much momentum. Coming through, turn around. Y'all, the fadeaway. And we got another big boost right here.
Very nice.
Going good through speed. This wind section. Snag that teensy along the way. Nice, barely slipping through, getting all those cycles.
Not taking time to kill any enemies because that's slow.
Oh, better making that cycle. Nice, nice.
Oh, ballsy cycle right there by
Preston. Huge
boost
coming up here at the end.
Very
good speed.
Nice.
That was a really good 2-5.
Oh, he needed a dash at the end. Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, outside the ledge grab. That was a very, very good 2-5. Hit all the cycles he wanted to.
Excellent.
Yo, let's get another quick donation or two.
Here we go.
By
we
got Lat before we get into
no
this boss.
No problem. We got $25 from DanceDad. DanceDad. DanceDad is enjoying this run of Rayman Legends. It's nice to see this game getting taken out quickly. My favorite levels were, of course, the music levels, but I will understand if they are skipped this go around. Put the money towards the first bonus game. Keep on grooving all and stay safe. Also, I have a $5 donation with a question, actually. This is a silly giraffe. I still don't know what Gandalf says in this game. I hear meatball every time. Does anyone doing commentary happen to know?
I say meatball every time. I believe that's the beginning of time. All right, so I promise you all, there was a boss here. But, yes!
And we're gone.
Yes!
Specifically, sorry. Go for it, Ted.
I just said boss complete. That's it.
I was gonna say he went out of his way to gather 70 mums there. The heart gives him an extra 5. That 75 gets him the ticket, and that's all you need to see.
Yeah. Normally that is a very long boss that killed a lot of us back in 2013 when we did runs. We were bad. It's not that bad of a boss, but yeah, it normally would take quite a while. You do lose out on the final two teensies that you would normally get in that fight, but with some good rerouting by DJ and the boys. I feel like I just gave you a podcast. Coming up with DJ and the boys, it's Rayman Legends routing. Wiggity, wiggity, wiggity. But now we're going in. Nils, do you want to explain a little bit about what these levels are?
Yeah, so this is our first invasion. And once we've done World 1 and World 2, which we now have, the enemies from World 2 actually come back to this level, 1-6, and kind of invade it. And the invasions are basically like the time attacks for this game. They're run a lot by the IL players. There's a very big IL community. Maybe Kane.
Very nice.
Can elaborate on that?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. So there's a very active IL community that has largely been sustained by the daily challenges since 2013. And so if you're wondering where a lot of this tech, not the boss skips, but in terms of just movement came from, it was from them. And that particular IL is a pretty awesome IL because there's so many YBY ups that just allow you to sail through it. So if you've never seen it before, it's quite impressive. So we got a really cool level coming up.
So good.
You want to give some play-by-play?
Yes. Yeah, we got shields up and down. First of all, you see a teensy on screen. You know what that means. Yay! And those never get old. And then maintaining all that speed with all of the somersaults and everything, great. Now we got Murphy. So now he's our new two-player, the true two-player in our heart. And he's going to be moving shields up and down for us, hence the name of the level. However, we're going to want to get on top of those shields in a lot of places, like right here, and actually just run off the end of them. Jump off rather before reaching the end, and then that's going to give us more speed going forward. Utilizing a damage boost right here to pop us up in the air off the burn, but smack that teensy and then get this, as far as I'm concerned, a Globox exclusive teensy right here. How did you not take damage? I don't know, but anyways, let's slap this teensy. Bam! All right, got it. Only Globox can do that clip right there. The powers of having big hands. You can palm a basketball and you can save teensies left and right. Now making our way back, getting all that new heart. Can get a big boost right here. Let's see if we can skip out on this ring. Very even nice. Right here. See your ring.
Skip all the
see
rings.
See a fireball. Good see speed. Enemies. Very nice.
Save another teensy
right there. Oh. Can you go for another YBY up? Oh no!
We're fine.
All good. But the save.
The infamous frames. Saved his life there.
Yo, what's up, Gandalf? Your boy coming in. All right, now dropping down, getting all these enemies out of the way. We got this big wind section with a lot of enemies right here. Yo, nice height. Getting over the enemy.
A lot of bouncing. Bouncing lets you to keep your momentum instead of hovering. So coming off the shields, you can save some speed.
All right, now getting off this shield. Now the finger of Zeus, and I kid you not, Zeus is about to come down. But we're actually going to clip in front of him. He's supposed to attack you right now, but we're going to stop strategically right now, then go. That teensy back there, we didn't save it. Zeus did. Thank you, Zeus. You are a merciful god. We snagged the last one, and that was a great fight one.
That's just like a really good level for, you know, keep the momentum, just lots of flow.
You see Depressing's happy about his level as well. Yeah. Yeah, that is one of my favorite levels in the entire run. But World 5, if I can describe them in music terms, bangers. Absolutely. Left and right. The music's also great in this game.
Yeah, amazing maze, great lava pursuit. I mean, you know.
Great lava pursuit,
to,
dude.
You don't have to do it in the run, but it's a cool level when done well.
No, but it is, yes, it is a good level. Oh, baby, two-player, I get excited every time. Gonna be smart, get up here on top of this cage and then spin back, cutting out any having to drop back down after getting the cage. Coming up on one of the only king or queen teensies that we'll be saving in this world. They're generally too long, but here by utilizing a damage boost off that heart we picked up, we can just pop right up and get a teensy. Making our way back up we go.
Using that bone wall for a break boost.
Yeah, reapplying a ground pound off of that to skip nice. Out on all of this
very
stuff.
Good.
Again, we like to spin as often as we can. Every time that you do a wall kick to the other side, that refunds your ability as well to spin again. You're constantly just trying to figure out how to stay in spin speed at worst in this game.
It's break boost there, and then a downhill slope, double jump, flop.
Oh, that was a good flop there.
Nice.
Yeah.
That was
smooth.
Oh, that was a disgusting
flop. Let's see if you can keep on the momentum
there. If y'all think it looks cool to you, to runners, this is disgusting.
Nice speed.
Nice reapplication of a ground pound. Big speed. And now we're just going to spin, wall kick, spin, wall kick, spin, wall kick.
Dodge that enemy, and there's the end.
Yo, nuts. Hold up. Another great level.
Did we ever explain why we came to World 5 already?
I think we did, didn't we?
I mean, I just brought up that, like, the routing options are there. Yeah. As soon as you get 65 TNCs, you can go there. But we didn't explain
why we're here.
It.
It's because if you go to World 3 or 4 early, you can't get to the end. So you just got to gather some TNCs at some point.
Another S-tier level right here. We got the amazing maze. There are actually no side room teensies. All 10 of them are along the route. So we're going to be snagging all 10 of them. First, utilizing kicking off this cage to actually go up through the exit point. Save that with Glowbox's big fist. Grabbing that teensy and then making our way back.
Nice.
Snagging this guy.
New little tech there.
And now let's see here. We got a fireball coming up on the next teensy. You know, nice going back right there. Let's see if we can avoid the fireball with
very
some swag.
Nice.
Oh, beautiful.
Is he going for it? Oh.
You say it's an obstacle. I say it helps me out. Supposed to be an enemy there. We killed him before he got to do anything.
Upside down. Who cares?
Very nice. God, this level goes so fast. We already have 18 seasons.
So good.
Yeah, I wish I could commentate on more, but it's just like it goes by so fast.
Oh, nice. Gets the right. YBY nice. Up by the ground pound there. Tail.
Yeah, Depressing.
Oh, got the skull token. Gonna lose about 3 frames for that.
Yeah.
Depressing plays on analog stick, so that YBY up right there is a little bit more difficult for him, but managed to do it very smoothly. And you're talking about YBY ups, there's another one coming in.
Yeah, large win right here.
Yeah, this one's free. Yeah, even
right
I
there.
Can do it.
Yes!
And drop down. Got World 5, they just keep coming. Depressing Child keeps knocking them down. Let's kick it over for a couple donations before we get into the last level of World 5 for now.
Absolutely. We have $10 from Snaily Syrup 53 that says, so glad everyone is back this year. Even though it's all online and everyone is remote, you all still know how to put on a great event. Let's speedrun breaking last year's donation record. And let's do one more. We have a $25 donation from Dame Juno that says, longtime fan of GDQ, first time donating. I love this event, and it starts on my birthday this year. Good luck on the runs, and happy birthday to you, Dame Juno.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, everyone, and thank you for this big slope, Ubisoft. Now we got a wall of enemies right here, but we don't care. Nice. We're just going to go right over them. That's actually tighter than he just made it look.
Another flop here, picking up this turnip TC, and good job. Nice crown pound.
Yeah, whenever you flop a TC that's a turnip TC in the ground, you pick them up instantly, or at least you extract them from the ground instantly, and then you can just tip them.
Yeah, effectively cuts out the little jump animation. So just an immediate ground pound. Can be difficult to go fast in this section right here. They kind of want to gate your progression, but DepressingChild doing a good job with it. Snapping this guy, a little cute boost. Boom.
Very nice.
Lost a little bit of speed at the end. That was pretty good.
I love the confidence right there to know that Crystal's going to be there in time. If he was about a frame earlier, he would have taken damage. Now, this is one of the hardest break boosts in the game.
It's inconsistent.
Right. Yeah, so the floor here is almost no friction, and so it's hard to get any kind of breaking force when there's no force. But, right. You know, all good.
All good. So with that, that is actually the final of the preliminary levels done here in World 5. The next level is actually the 260 Teensy requirement level. You can see it right there to the right. So that's our ultimate goal. And we're going to have to come back here later on. We got enough Teensies from World 5 because no matter what, we're going to have to break up World 5. And this makes it to where now we can basically just do Worlds 3 and 4 in one shot. Going into Spoiled Rotten, we're going to be checking out Tiny Glowbox, Itty Bitty Glowbox.
So Tiny Glowbox, although small, still has momentum available. There's a lot of different techniques that you can use with like the roll jump, and that stuff still applies, and you'll be able to use that to, you know, quickly navigate through the levels.
Shoutouts to Satellite Internet.
I promise you, everything he's doing is
killer.
He's
actually going so fast that the stream can't keep up.
Yeah, exactly.
Satellite can't keep up. There was a boost right back there. Frame perfect, sub-pixel perfect. And right here, all of you soccer fans, I'm sorry, we're not using it.
Double jump into the cage, easy.
All right, now we got this pretty technical climb right here, trying to get in those ground pounds when he can. He's trying to catch an early cycle. Very nice, able to grab that horn, sending him back Tiny so he can get a couple of teensies in this next section.
Will do.
And also, if you were wondering, yeah, that's right, it's Butter. Using that clip off the damage boost and allows him to get a better cycle getting out of the watermelon. Whole bunch of stuff over there, but we're not going to utilize any of it. We're just going to climb that right wall and use that bumper. All right, the hardest part of the run. Oh. The hole in one.
Oh, hole in two. Nice. That's par.
Any of you who might remember my AGDQ 2016 run about it, I think I got a hole in seven. I promise it is
it's
one.
A lot harder
it's sub
than it
pixel
should be.
Perfect. Yeah. It is very hard to get into that watermelon. So Spoiled Rotten, down. Then you want to explain a little bit about this next level we got coming up and
yeah,
what we
so
just skipped over.
You can see a level behind us we decided to completely neglect. There's a reason for that. It's a duck level, and the first duck level in this world is really, really slow. We don't have to explain any further. It's just not going to be a level we do. We have the opportunity to skip it, so we might as well skip it. But this duck level, we aren't skipping because it's actually pretty fast for what it is. And I also unironically enjoy this level despite it being quite different and technically not as interesting, but I still like it.
I mean, you still have momentum. Yeah. You still can bounce. You still got slopes. Speaking of slopes,
right there.
We got speed.
Yeah. I love that slope being right there because you automatically think, oh, this is going to be like an auto-scroller effectively for speedrunners, and then immediately slope, immediately keeping a lot of speed. This is the next level where he's also going to want to collect 450 lums, so you're going to see him snagging things here and there. It's not really costing him any time because he's still moving forward. Just going slightly out of his way sometimes in slower animations. But again, we want those 450 lumps so we can get that lucky ticket so we can get to more fast levels later on. We've got a lot of speed we can build up off this slope.
Okay. Very nice momentum.
Oh, keeping it all the way through to the skull
token. Timing right there was very tricky to spawn the Murphy platform in time, but managed to do it pretty well.
Yep. Very nice.
And yeah, maybe we should mention that Murphy's actually putting out guacamole platforms for anyone who's wondering.
Oh yeah, and you successfully, Nils, I am now hungry. Yo, we got any guacamole fans in the chat? Not? Oh God, shut up, please, I am. All right, what's the best dip? Guacamole or hummus, salsa?
Like a nice to go with thick salsa. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like a chunky salsa.
I like the chunky stuff. Yeah. Are we spicy fans
Absolutely.
Here? We're it's the duck level, so we're doing this.
What else is there to talk about?
Yeah, in fact, maybe there's some guacamole-based donations that are going on right now. Oh, the big skip, trying to go up the left side. Oh, but we're going to utilize the right side because I talked over it. Nice keeping the momentum actually here off those somersaults. Again, for it being a duck level, very technical. But with that, we're at the end of the level. We've got the right amount of lums. Let's go ahead and ask Lat to read some more donations before we get into the next level. Snakes on a cake, an eventful
one. Well, now is your chance to get in the guac donations. But before then, we have had some watermelon donations. Gives me a chance. That gives me a chance to tell you about upcoming watermelon ending we have as an incentive, folks. We need $5,000. That's the goal. We're at $2,800 right now. Please get those donations in so we can see the watermelon ending of ICO.
Can you believe this is unironically the watermelon block of the marathon? Even the games committee didn't know they scheduled this. We're going into snakes on a cake. There's a lot of technical stuff going on out of here. We're going to try to catch an early cycle. Ooh. Barely slipped Globot.
Oh, he's
through.
Very nice.
Getting
very
through there. Cycle. Oh, very nice. Still got it off the damage boost. That's going to make this upcoming Queen C very difficult. We're going to utilize somersaults to climb this wall. And then instead of using soccer for the third time, we're not going to utilize soccer. Get down, get the teensy. Very nice, skipping out on the damage. That's actually really hard to do that damageless. Now barely slipping by, getting this teensy, and then we're gonna swish up against this wall. That snake's a coming, and it's helping you, damage boosting you through that bumper right there, or through that horn. Now gonna do another ground pound from below, giving ourselves a lot of distance, a lot of violence off of that. Grabbing that teensy cycle with plenty of time to spare.
Nice little double dash there off the heart. Not very useful here, but you might have seen him use it elsewhere in the run, where you're able to dash in an object as tiny glow box, and it gives you double speed.
Right there. Fortunately, missing that first cycle there. I had to go for the second, but not a big deal.
Yeah, been a really good snakes on a cake so far. Great recovery off that opening. Now gonna drop down. Oh, had one of those weird, almost like glitchy ones where it shot him up into the ceiling instead. Now we're gonna try to skip out on a cutscene right here. We're gonna snag this teensy. Start dropping down. He's got to catch this early cycle with the snakes. Got to move really fast.
Nice.
So we get a ground pound right here. And nice skipping out on
the
cutscene.
Claps.
That massive cutscene skip saved 1.5 seconds. There was a lot going on in that cutscene, you gotta realize.
there's a chase sequence in every world, I believe, where you have to watch that, and, you know, it's very dramatic.
I mean, you can skip the cutscene anyway, but we skip it even more, essentially.
Yeah, we hard skip it. Unless you are sadly... So they patched a lot of things for this game on, like, PS4, Xbox One. The saddest... I was going to say inclusion, but I guess getting rid of it would definitely be you can't skip that cutscene anymore. They made the trigger for the cutscene massive. So we lose 1.5 seconds on PS4, but we have no load screen, so that's pretty cool.
You take some, you lose some, right?
So now as we go into the mini boss of this world, I'm lying. We're going back to the invasion level.
So for invasions to trigger, you have to beat the level, and then you also have to beat with the boss of the world that they come from. And in this case, you had to beat the level after the level. And then you get an invasion. So more will unlock as you go.
Yeah. And you need a specific amount of teensies to unlock it. Like it's, yeah, there's like three or four different things the game checks for. At the end of the day, if there is an invasion available, we're probably going to do it in the 80% route because these are only three teensies, but they're all consistently, they all have to be under 40 seconds.
And fun fact, you can do them all in under 30 seconds. This one's pretty challenging. 31.11 is a really good time. But there's an IL community challenge to beat all the invasions in under 30 seconds. And it's down to under 27 seconds now. Two people have done that, which is pretty crazy. But we looked it up the other day, and there was like 67 people who have gotten the all sub 30s, which is pretty incredible as well.
That's insane. One of the bigger damage boosts utilizing that heart right there, we're going to grab this teensy and then just barely slip under and let that pop us up instead of having to wait for all that lava. Or this food-based level. I don't know. Is that like tomato sauce or something? I don't know.
Maybe
know
it's getting hungry. Spicy something.
Ooh.
It could be tomato sauce,
spicy sauce.
Because it's the same stuff as the Rayman Origins red stuff.
Oh, true.
From the cooking levels.
Chess Rayman Origins, the prequel to this. This is mostly a auto scroller, you would think. Oh, no, you can keep running. That luchador back there, actually, if you go too fast, which is surprisingly not hard to do because I was able to do it back in the day, if you go too fast, it despawns this giant luchador. And then you can't finish the level. So, DepressingChild is going fast, but controlled fast. Trying to realize when to slow down. If he hasn't lost him by this point, he's not gonna lose him. Also, I have to do this every time we get to this point in the run. Shout outs to Uranium Anchor right here as he's going down. I just want to clarify with everyone, that is a thumb. That is a thumb. Shout outs to Uranium Anchor 7 years ago for coming in my chat and thinking that was a different finger right there. I said, it's a Terminator reference. What are you talking about? He apparently thought it was a very weird looking thumb.
Anyway, obviously. But
so that's our mini boss right there. We got now the boss fight coming up, and Kane, I'm kicking it over to you,
so
my dude.
The World 3 boss is very long, and there's really not much you can do. And we thought, what better time to talk about the lore than now? For anybody who doesn't know the lore. Rayman Legends has lore. You're in a tent, right? Because it's a play. This is all a giant play. And there's five separate tales about how Rayman and his friends defeat Mr. Dark. And the Dark Teensy at the end is a Teensy playing the part of Mr. Dark. And that's why it's called Rayman Legends. There's five separate legends about defeating Mr. Dark.
As a theater actor, I love that lore, and it all actually makes sense, and that's really cool. With the rest of that, though, this is definitely the least interesting of the bosses in the run. We're going to be slapping the teensies. He's got a second player in, so we can bonk him on the head actually a little earlier, saving him a few seconds. We're also just going to abuse him throughout it. But as we make our way to the end of the boss, Lat, this is Donation City. Go for it, my
dude.
Let's
start off with this one because you asked for it and they have come through.
Oh, no.
Bruno Fightmaster.
Yes.
First donations of many this GDQ. Shout outs to Guac as one of the best chip dips out there. Put this money towards Watermelon Ending to continue this foodie block. Now I'm hungry as well, okay? Hopefully next time I'll be able to laugh and enjoy this level instead of remote. True statement. Then we have another $25 from Nerdstalgic that says, super pumped for SGDQ 2020. I discovered GDQ and speedrunning earlier this year, and I can't get enough. Good luck to all the runners this week. And finally, we have a $50 anonymous donation, and this is the first time I played through ICO. I literally cried. This time, I expect there will be tears of joy. To all the GDQ staff, thank you so much for working so hard to do some good when it's needed the most. To chat, Watermelon Hype!
Hype!
If we got any more donations, this boss just keeps going. We've actually got like 20 more minutes of this boss. It's great. I don't know how they let this in the marathon.
Well, let's get through some then. Chroma 136, $25. Thanks for everything you do. Game Junkie 89 for $30. Super stoked for another GDQ. I can't wait to see all the runs. Me too as well, Game Junkie. This is exciting.
And there
let's see,
it is.
We have. Oh, okay, finally.
Final hit, but we've got menuing afterwards. But yeah, final hit, boss defeated.
Time for more food-based donations. Once again.
This is your chance, folks, to send in the guac. Everyone, every guacamole donation is truly welcomed right now as we're working our way towards the ICO watermelon ending bid war. It's at $5,000. We need $5,000 and we're at $2,873. Folks, you can still make this happen. We still have time in this run to make that goal.
Yeah, please, everyone, get them in. It's going to be an awesome run of ICO, ICO, however you say it. And shouts to the runner of that, Bucci. She's a known Spyro and Crash runner as well, other great speedrun series. So, yeah, make sure to get in that support. Now we go into the mysterious inflatable island, which is all going to be happy, lovely, you know, fun time. Deep dive. Swimming levels, I'm terrible at it. Someone else explain how to be good at swimming levels.
Swimming is fundamentally you've got one thing you can do. You can use analog to control yourself, which fortunately our runner is doing, and you can dash. And the dashes are kind of weird to control. First, the dashes still renew underwater, just like on land, where you hit an enemy or an object, and you refresh your dash meter. And that's gonna be really important. But the other thing is when you dash, it's not a immediate dash in the direction that your analog stick is pointed at that very moment. It's like a compound weird trajectory of the direction your character is facing and the direction you're holding on the analog stick. So it's really difficult to get straight lines, but the amount of time you can save by having a really good line is unfathomably high.
Ooh, barely making that cycle. Very nice. So we're going to try to get this. Ooh, we're going to need that teensy. He's part of the club. And nice. Once again, as Nils brought up earlier, bringing in that second player, and it actually makes the respawn animation off the death a little faster. Oh, no. We're going for the intentional death abuse plus two. Quite a strategy.
And before you guys panic.
Grabbing a token.
Before you guys
panic,
we did get that teensy. It was another death abuse teensy. You got it.
Yeah. Yeah, just to make sure. That is one of the, possibly the last. I forget.
I think it is.
The last of those we'll be able to do. So now we'll be going into 4-2. Like, the other stuff, just like as a level mechanic, hazard-wise, those deadly lights, which the next level is actually called the deadly lights, we're going to be seeing more of those. And there's a lot of routing out, knowing how to move through them when you actually do want to touch being in the light so that they stop moving, so that there's less distance for you to go through it, and maybe it opens up a later path later on. There's so much to understand and optimize. World 4, I always thought was the hardest world to run in any percent for me personally.
Yeah, I'd say that's probably accurate.
I gotta say, I agree 100%.
Yeah, and Nils is actually good. Nils, one of the other top three runners, along with Depressing Child.
Yeah, the record's
here.
Actually been going back and forth quite a bit recently, so definitely.
Okay, there is a teensy down there. What's happening?
Bed? You want to explain that?
So there's a section there where an enemy has a weird electric ball gun or whatever it is. I don't know what to call it. But
laser cannon.
It's a gun that can technically ricochet off of like walls and stuff. So we kept that pipe there at a certain angle that the gun can actually get the TNC for you. So we don't have to actually get it. And we can actually take advantage of that pipe that we kept up and use it as a slope to keep our, not keep the, to maintain our speed.
All right, now we're keeping that heart right now for a big damage boost, saving about a continent's worth of movement they have to get rid of. Very nice. Now we want to spin into these little thin pipeways and start wiggling our way through it.
Nope.
Oh, very nice.
Oh, my God.
That was a little awkward. A long checkpoint. Oh, well. All good.
Yeah, we were about to move too fast there, but he tried to move back quickly, but a bit too quick, and now he was too far behind, so he died for that.
Yeah, he retracted too fast, yeah. Expecting to die, and yeah, but.
Again, anybody, yo, nice YBY up right there. Again, anyone who's coming in a little bit later, keep in mind that he's controlling both of these characters, both Globox and Murphy. Knowing how to get Murphy to snap to certain platforms is all about your positioning on the screen. If he tries to tell Murphy, yo, nice skipping out on the silver cup right there. $2.99 calculated. But if he is just barely too early with telling Murphy with his button inputs to go to another platform and move it, Murphy will still be stuck on the prior platform. So all of a sudden, the cycles are not lined up at all how you want it. It's very, very difficult to optimize the Murphy levels, all of it in this game, but the Murphy levels especially. Now he's gonna try to catch an early cycle right here, go off the right side. Beautiful.
Yeah, this is definitely one of the hardest levels in the game, I would say, because it's all room-based, and there's a lot of pipes and objects, and you got Murphy again, and so there's just tons of stuff to manage, lots of enemies, and it's just a mess to try and navigate quickly.
Gonna go for a sexy YBY up through the bone wall right here.
Very nice.
Very nice. Skipping out on moving around. All right, now we have to point it out now, otherwise you'll have no idea he's saving a teensy right here. This pipe he's about to go through, there is a teensy from above getting beat up by an enemy. We're going to roll and do an attack right there that actually killed the enemy from below, saving the teensy and cutting out on us having to move up there, saving out a number of seconds.
Now we get a nice little stealth, very slow Murphy room. Gotta move the light right, left, right. And if you touch it at all, this light is very zappy.
Mm-hmm. Big, big zaps.
Got another co-op boost coming up.
Yeah, yep. This one's great. I don't know what the puzzle is in this level, cause see ya.
Yeah. All right.
Pausing.
Mash that refresh button.
Yep.
With moving the lights back and forth here as Murphy, you're trying to optimize not moving it too much in any one direction so there's less to go through on the other way. Now we're going to make our way through here and utilize this heart for another damage boost. Take it in the corner and then move through the door immediately. And now, if you're all lucky enough to see this, this last room was very cool.
It actually looks okay on stream. Just our side, it's a bit laggy, looks like.
Yeah, it finally fixed on my end.
Oh, now it's lagging my cap. Okay. Once again, shoutouts to Satellite Internet. I swear, that room was pretty cool.
Yeah, that room is very cool. There's like a big skip. There's 18 frame perfect inputs.
Speaking of things that are very cool, crazy. We got a level packed full of auto scrollers coming up next.
Oh, mama. I am looking forward to the food-based donations coming up. This is, unfortunately, the longest level in the main campaign, right?
Maybe. One of them.
Is it longer than Grave? It's got, like Kane is saying, there are two long auto-scrollers in it. There's a lot of cool stuff when we're not in the auto-scrollers. But yeah, it's elevator ambush. So for theming purposes, there had to be two elevators. So during those, we will be kicking it over to Lat to read some more of y'all's generous donations as we try to get Watermelon, whatever Watermelon that incentive was for Ico. Watermelon ending, that's right. Let's see here. We're probably in an elevator.
Trust us. You're not going to be missing much. You're not missing much.
Yeah. I feel like we're in one by now. Lat, go for some donations.
No problem. Let's keep the donation trade going, folks. Okay, here we go.
Don't worry, crew. You're not missing anything. Go for it.
Okay, have a $5 anonymous donation, and I'm going to try my best here to do some voices. What does an avocado say?
Quack, quack, quack.
Please forgive me.
You didn't write it, did you?
Good point.
All these donations are by Lat. He's revealing right now.
I am given donates $250. Wait, someone said watermelon, and it's pronounced eco. Okay. Not sure what that means, but there you go.
Neither one of us said it correctly then, so we're both in the clear. All right.
Well, you know, what are you going to do? Okay, let's see.
All right, so we got non-auto-scroller section.
Yeah, we got another elevator coming for you in a second.
There's a swimming section here, lots of missiles. And one thing to note is if you get near the tips of the missiles, you can renew your dash. So, yeah, there's a few of those where he did renew his dash by just approaching a missile. But kind of navigate through another swimming section and then moving on to more elevator.
The fun stuff.
Cue the donations.
Even more donations. Yeah.
For more exciting elevator action, keep donating, folks. We have a Green Geek $36 donation. Summer, 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 summer GDQ. Ho! Also, let's see, we also have a $100 donation with no comment from Ronze158. Thank you so much for the $100. Here is another $100 donation from Sandra229 that says, GDQ is exactly what the world needs right now. Big thanks to everyone involved. Also, let's make Ori happen.
Oh, that one's already open. We got a bonus game coming up for Ori.
I don't know if it's live yet, man. But it's it will be soon if it's not.
It will be. Okay, yeah. Again, guys, lots of awesome bonus game runs going on in this marathon. Check out the schedule. You can see all of them posted there. Tons of great incentives, including the watermelon ending, which, as someone who has not played Eco, I'm sorry, I look forward to whatever a watermelon is in that game.
So we're wrapping up this level here. We got another chase sequence. Nice little double jump there to skip a platforming segment.
Now here's the chase sequence. Got another section of swimming right here. And the dark teensy you're chasing actually has a hitbox. So every time you spin into it, you're actually refunding that spin over and over and over again. So you can actually move yourself forward pretty aggressively here. Cutting that corner, taking the damage boost.
It's on top of the water there, just for swag.
I mean, it saves time. You're
does
resistant.
It? Yeah. Nice.
But it looks really cool.
Air resistance doesn't have as much resistance as water resistance. So.
Perfect.
Yeah. Fun fact. Fun physics.
Optimal.
I feel like I subscribe to the something can be swag and save time.
Yeah.
If it just looks right. Really cool. So some games, like if you're playing like Celeste, it's just swag. The whole game is just swagging everywhere. But Rayman Legends getting there as well. I want to give, once again, a shout-out to the individual level community for losing their PC servers and coming over and making this game such a better speedrun already from the RTA standpoint.
Rest in peace, PC servers. You will be missed.
Yeah. I'm glad y'all got bored enough to come over here.
Last time the servers went down, we hacked the game. So this time we did something a little bit more speedrun productive.
I'm going to take it over to Nils. Nils, talk a little bit about this very difficult level right here that DepressingChild
is doing. This is the mini-boss level of World 4, and there's basically this chase sequence, and you're going to see him cutting these corners very aggressively here.
Wow.
Nice. That's... I'd say Depressing is the most aggressive player with these corners, playing it really well right now.
Yeah, really good to not take any damage through there. And this is one of the most important hearts in the game. It saves 20 minutes coming up in about 30 seconds. So, going to get through this section, a very awkward section to go fast in, but DepressingChild doing all he can, barely getting in front of and over the top of all these spiked balls and everything.
Oh, no.
Oh, murder.
That checkpoint is very far away. This is a very tough section. It's an easy place to die, but it's also a really slow place to die, unfortunately.
Wants to keep this hard. He still wants to save the 20 minutes coming up. It actually wrong warps into the end of the game. And very nice. Taking that laser damage back there, skipping out on all of that stuff. And happen. Yeah, probably something in the happened. End. He swam up. You y'all saw the good stuff.
Again. Can't see what's happening.
And then you flush the nerd down the toilet. And that's what you do in all speedruns right there.
Very
yeah,
nice.
It was good. Job. Trust me. Honestly, what you all were able to see, all the cutting of the corners, he was frames away from getting shot by each of those lasers. So the fact that he did that section damageless, yeah, really, really good.
That level was pretty much flawless. So, we're off to the boss of World 4. This is, in my opinion, the most exciting part of the run. Because recently, yes. Boss skip was discovered in the third phase of this boss. So let's see if he can pull it off.
Big two-player boost right there. Also turn around real quick to get that fadeaway on the Teensy. Now we're actually going to use two players for... Tell me a little bit about this tech, then.
So this is like one of the weirdest tricks in the game.
Nice.
It's first similar try. To a co-op boost, but not really.
Very nice.
It allows you to clip your second player that stands on top of you through walls, essentially. I don't know how else to explain it that makes any sense. I will say it is an animation-related bug specifically for Glowbox, but that's all I can really explain briefly that isn't, like, making me run on a tangent.
Yeah, so basically he zipped the character through. Yeah, go for it, Nils.
Okay, yeah, basically he could teleport himself through the wall, triggering that next phase, which allows him to not wait out for the 10 or so seconds you'd have to otherwise.
And it's not the first time we'll be seeing it on this level. We'll be seeing it again very yep. soon.
Alright, here we are in phase two of the boss. This one doesn't really have any speedrun strats to it. Here's all I'm gonna say. Here's my tutorial on phase two of boss four. Don't miss this cycle. Unironically, you lose like 30 seconds if you miss
it's
this
cycle.
It's
not just this boss, like that's a common thing in Rayman Legends, is if you screw up and you go slow on a boss cycle, you're gonna pay with like a three times longer segment. Mm-hmm. This little skip going underneath.
Right, so now we're
going
to go for another co-op boost nice. Right here. All right, here's the big one.
Nice.
Oh, the big boost right here. He's going to try to hover over the final phase.
Yep, so he ground pounded off an invisible bouncer. Now he's landing on the invisible floor. There's actually an invisible wall there that kills you. So he utilizes the co-op zip going through the wall. And we skip the third phase.
Very nice.
Absolutely perfect. That was awesome.
That's probably the single hardest trick in the game. That saves the most time.
Yeah, and it looks so good, that amount of air time you get off it. And picking up his 10th and final lucky ticket of the run. Thank you, Co-op Boost. Thank you, Co-op Zip.
Yep.
Thank you, Glowbox, for having weird properties.
Glowbox is special. There's a reason this game should be called Glowbox Legends instead, to be honest.
We'll make it happen. When's the Glowbox Legends mod gonna happen?
I think we're watching it right here. All right, and now back into evasion. So we've completed the first four worlds of the game. We still have to get to the fifth world's mini boss and corresponding boss. So before that, we need to go and fill out that 260 Teensy Cal. You're gonna see a lot of ILs, the invasion levels, and a few other levels here and there. The scary thing about the invasions being all bunched up here at the end of the run is that this is definitely a choke point for a lot of runners. Cause deaths in Rayman Legends generally are only like, you know, a couple seconds here and there. You can have some of the worst ones be like 15, 20 seconds.
Ooh.
Ooh, but as you can see right there.
That's a 27.49 second death.
The 30 second plus death right there with the load screen.
So painful to watch.
Yeah, that is where it's so difficult. These are absolutely fast enough to be in the route, but it's painful when you can take those deaths. But it's okay, we can see more of this awesome movement, getting there in front of that lasered up piece of hunk of junk, whatever it is. From that giant enemy.
Random little chunk of cake disappears there, don't ask.
Nice jump off the water spout right there. And that'll be the last invasion we take in World 3.
Yep.
Now I believe we'll be making our way over to World 2 invasions. We got three to do there and our only princess level. Another massive co-op boost. And again, it's from what I understand from you guys, I've not personally done the technique. It's just because you have two players that it specifically puts you at this top speed.
Yeah, standing on the lower player when you attack and then jump off at the right time.
So clean.
It just happens.
God, that was so hot. Do it again. Die and go back.
But yeah, that this level just sail. You fly. It's incredible.
Yeah, almost sub. Forget 40 seconds. We got almost half that.
And for the record, even single player runs would have been faster than 20 seconds.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
The IL community has been brimming for the last 7 years. And again, they just took them getting bored and losing their PC servers. All right, on to our next invasion level. This one can be tough, very easy to take a death late in it, but it's mainly just trying to chain your balances and everything. There's not a lot of like super technical stuff going on here, so I think it's okay for us to kick it over lap to maybe, my bad.
Let's try that again.
Yeah. As you're seeing this repeat footage right here, Lat, give us a donation or two.
Give us a replay.
Absolutely. Well, this is a perfect time then for how about a guac recipe from Guac Recipe. Donates $25.
Nice.
4 ripe avocado mashed well or left slightly chunky. 1 jalapeno minced small 3 clove garlics grated. 1 small or half large red onion chopped. Medium small 2 to 3 medium ripe red tomatoes or a dozen or so cherry tomatoes chopped. 1 whole lime. A juice handful of cilantro chopped, and then there's optional salt and pepper to taste. Mash the avocados, mix in the lime juice, salt, pepper to mix, and jalapeno, garlic, onion, fold into the tomato and cilantro. Serve with chips or on sourdough toast.
Oh.
Thank you so much, Guac Recipe.
Yes, do all of that. And then serve it to my house. Guacamole is still S tier. It's still number one. The thing is, it, hummus, and salsa all are S tier, so it's fine.
Or queso as well. We didn't mention queso.
Oh, we didn't even say queso. Yeah. Oh, my God.
Queso is the champ. Let's be real.
The chat has you covered there. There was definitely a lot of queso chat discussion in the chat.
Oh, really? Do you have any of the... Oh, okay, the chat. I thought you were saying, yeah, donations. Thank you, chat. GDQ chat. 209,
by the way. Absolutely. And 209 donates $5 and says, I'll bring the tortilla chips for all this guac.
Perfect. Great.
Very cycle-based invasion level that he just got down with. 2828. Who called 2828 in the chat?
I'd be surprised.
Did anyone? There's a $500 prize on the line if you make it.
Wow.
I won't be giving it out, but I'm somewhere out there. We should have been playing the guessing game with all these invasion levels.
All right, so princess level.
Yes. It's the only princess level in the run. Tell
the
us
the reason
about
for
it.
That. Go for it. Who's going to...
Yeah, who's going to tell us? You fall down a lot, really fast.
You ground pound, you fall, you go fast. This is kind of based off of the easy pit challenges, like the daily challenges, and there's not very many objects that kill you in those. There's a few spikes, but you know, it's just a lot of dew.
And we're already done. That's it.
Yeah.
Yep.
You can see the UI is still like, I'm still getting the second one in here. Oh, God. Give me a second. Okay, there's 3. 114 laps. We get, like, none of them there.
Yeah, that's the only reason we run that level, because it's just so fast, and there's no other princess level that's this fast normally. Like, the next princess level that's next fastest is 10 seconds slower. It's that fast.
There's, like, 3 of them that are 10 seconds slower.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the ones you can do in World 3, they're based off the Land of the Livid Dead levels. Those are very cool, but unfortunately too slow. And now, it's time for Lucky Tickets. Step right up, Depressing Child, and try your luck. Unfortunately, this is not luck-based.
Fortunately.
Very, very fortunately.
This would be a horrible 1,000 luck base.
I didn't know. You hear lucky tickets and you think, oh, well, is it random? They are pseudo-random. What he does know is the 5th and 10th ticket that you scratch, no matter what levels they come from, will always give you 2 different Rayman Origins levels, the precursor game to Rayman Legends. The 7th, 8th, or 9th ticket, as you can see right there, that 8th one just had a single teensy. He knows one of those 3 will have a single teensy, and the 5th and 10th tickets will give him his 2 desired levels that he wants. So for the purpose of how we're using it at any percent, there's no RNG. Thankfully. Because it's going to be terrible. And so this allows us to gain access to two more 10 Teensy levels. In total, we're going to get 18 more Teensies from scratching tickets, skipping out on a couple of very slow levels that we could have otherwise done in the main campaign of the game. And yeah, these are levels here basically like somewhat HD-ified retakes on the Rayman Origins levels. Big co-op boost right here at the start. Very nice. Stepping on that button so he can get those birds down there to bounce off them. Snag another Teensy out of the ground right here. And best original score, one of my favorite tracks in the game. I guess one technically of the best from Rayman
the original score.
Mm-hmm. Now coming up, we got another Teensy. We're going to snag it from below. Anybody can do this one. I promise you there was a Teensy up there and he saved it. Depressing Child is a gentleman. Going out to save the world. Big ground pound right there to bounce him upwards. Skipping out on the birds.
Wonder if you could YBY up off of that sack there.
Oh, that's a good point. Going for a flop nice right flop. Here. Another well-executed flop. Flops damage are not easy experience to do, and he's done it for, like, all of them you can.
Yeah, so flops, if you know, for anyone who's curious what they are, they're just a variation of the YBI where you press down during it. And if you press up properly, you get a YBY up. If you press down, you get a flop. It's just another name of one of the techniques.
Basically, after a while, the community got tired of calling everything a YBY up, down, left, right, middle, around the corner. So eventually they started giving names to enough. It's a flop.
Or it actually was different where the flop got named before we knew how it worked.
Oh, really? Okay.
Well, the YBY up was named as, like, it literally post. Just, oh, you add in a up to a YBY and you get a YBY up.
We haven't wound up throughout the run, but yeah, we're cutting out a lot of the kind of overworld movement by utilizing our suitcase, the menu right there. That allows us to just warp straight to levels we want to get to. Back here, get this little tricky Teensy back there. And now, shout outs to this enemy, the scariest enemy in the game.
In there. Very nice.
Oh, it had mercy.
In and out.
That if it wants pissed. To, it literally can warp to you and eat you. It's bad.
And for the record, this was patched out in future re-releases of the game. So the PS4, Xbox One, and the Switch versions were patched to remove that hand completely. So that's just the free section. Yeah.
That tells you how messed up the enemy was. Their only way to figure out how to patch was, I guess, just take it out. Like, that's all they do. I'm sorry for making Ubisoft sound southern there. I don't know why I went there. But Goldbox again, having that big reach, taking out another Teensy right there. Now snagging the King Teensy right here.
You gotta kill all the enemies before you unlock the cage. But it's still quite quick, obviously.
Yeah, that's a theme of Rayman that Rayman Origins utilized, the mechanic of it. It'll be the same for the last room coming up here. Yeah, other than that, trying to cut out on actually getting shot out of the water in that first part so you can get to that Teensy. Making our way through, skipping out on the slow chain climb. And now he just has to optimize this last room, taking out each of the nerds. One end nerd, two nerd, three nerd, four nerd, nerd.
Very nice.
Nerd.
Nice.
I couldn't say it all fast enough. I got tongue twisted. Saving the cage and moving on. So that should put us at 248 Teensies right now. We need four more invasion levels, all from World 1 before we get there. Lat, let's get a few more donations in. We got the end of the run coming up soon.
This is exciting, and as the run gets towards the end here, we have shifted to the watermelon donations. King and Commoner 226 donates $50 and says, watermelon, watermelon, watermelon. Saying it three times summons it, right? Hopefully, my tongue got a little twisted there.
I know.
Also, this is a big one. Mince94 donates $1,000. Thank you so much, Mince94. So hype. Thank you so much. Keep it coming, folks.
Yeah, how are we doing on that watermelon ending right now? I'm invested. I haven't played the game.
Well, now I realize that I definitely have been mispronouncing it, but we're getting closer. We're at $3,547. We need another $1,500, folks, to get to the eco run for the watermelon ending. Please, this is your chance. We still have some time. Get it in.
Depressing Child is giving you all time, taking the death abuse strats at the beginning of Isles. Not recommended for your speed runs, but recommended for getting in those donations. So you want to see us get to that $5,000 for the watermelon ending.
You don't die there very often, so you probably don't think about the fact that if you die, you gotta kill both players to reset.
I was wondering what was happening right there. Gonna utilize the right wall right there. Very nice.
Goes under. Very important.
Oh man, is this the sub 30? It is.
Nice.
Sub 30 ropes sure course Kane, is actually very solid.
I'm sure Kane, as the ropes course connoisseur, could probably, you know, not be totally approved of that run, but.
No, that was fine.
All right, the votes are in chat. It is fine.
Okay.
Now, more than fine, though, we've got an very cool strat coming up here. The two players are going to come in for not only the beginning here, but we've got a very big shortcut coming up. So spawns player two again, flies over there, is now going top route. Now, most people don't go top route, and the reason for that is because they're not gods or playing with two people. There is a single player strategy to do that exact same thing, and it's insane. But it saves like a solid second in this level. It's pretty crazy.
Which again, a second might be like, oh yeah. We're talking about 32 seconds here, so saving a frame is pawn.
It's also
in this
easier.
Game.
Like get the top route, everything afterwards, you don't have to deal with all the nonsense below. So it's pretty sick.
Two more invasions right here to get our last 16 seeds. We're going into whatever that level is called. I forgot the name of the creepy castle or something. I don't know. Creepy castle invaded. It's gonna be the last bit of swimming we see throughout the run. It's a very cool IL that you get to see both swimming and above ground being optimized.
Yeah, you get a lot of jumping in and out of the water, which it's kind of a not a something you would think about, but there are ways to go into the water with dash speed as well as come out of the water with dash speed. Ends up being a pretty cool invasion.
And again, every time he goes through an enemy, a bone wall or anything, that is refreshing his ability to get another dash in.
28-28
again, the consistency, ladies and gentlemen.
Yo, can we get a 28-28 donation train going right now?
Surely someone actually vouched for that time at some point to get the $500.
That's pretty, about to say, did anyone call? All right, we got our final invasion level, everyone. With me giving you no prior knowledge,
donate your predictions.
Time. Yeah, donate your time predictions or post them in the chat right now. What will we get here on the final invasion level? Once upon a time, I'll give you one hint. It has to be under 40 seconds or we can't complete the run. Utilizing these brains, going off the butter, going up top, barely snagging that bone.
Very
right
nice
there.
End. Yeah.
And also for the record, this invasion is one of the longest invasions we do in the run because of those room transitions. It pauses the timer, but it doesn't pause real time, so it is wasting time. Going
it
rooms.
Actually ends up being like 1 or 2 seconds faster than, is it the World 4 dragon sequence.
Yeah, bigger fish or whatever.
There's always a bigger fish, yeah.
Yo, 29.74. Did we get any 29.74s in chat? Unfortunately, we had 169.69 and 828.28s. All of you, don't worry. You'll get to play in 4.5 years again when Rayman Legends is back. But for now, that's 260 teensies, and we're on to probably what still ranks as my favorite level in the run. Four boss is now one of them, for sure. But hell breaks loose. Nils, do you want to explain a little bit about what this level is supposed to be and what we're actually going to see?
Yeah, so this is the mini-boss level for the last world, World 5. And you're going to see all this kind of pits is going to fall through. Normally, you're supposed to run very slowly down. But the person doesn't like going slow, so he just falls.
Oop. All good.
All good.
Losing the heart there, but should be fine.
Yeah, you don't necessarily route in a damage boost. Ideally, you never take damage, so basically he just lost his save right here. I love this little wall kick. Cute!
Yep.
That's such a simple little wall kick. We never thought to do it. But yeah, again, supposed to wall run here, like Nils is saying. But that's slow, so we're going to try to just drop down. Now, the thing is, these dragons, they're chasing you, and they rubber band like it's an N64 cart-based game.
And we also have Murphy, so making it even harder.
Yeah, so he has to know when to barely apply a hover to let Murphy get into position so he can move a platform or snap a rope out of the way, whatever he has to do. Big drop down section right here. Snap this, fall down. Dragons are coming for him. Teensies are being caged up left or right, but we're not going to get him. Dropping all the way down. No safety hovers. And now we're going down the slope. Going to get a lot of speed. Skipping out on killing the first dragon because this is a pacifist run, but the pacifist run is over, so we just killed the second one. Now taking out the third one. Big double jump right there.
And for the record, falling down this level is about three to four times faster than running down it, because your max falling speed is like 3 or 4 times faster than trying to spin.
I think it's like 50 meters per second something.
It's 56-ish meters per second. Okay. And you can like spin jump on through the wall run section like 13 meters per second. So it's significantly faster just to fall.
Yep.
Also, real quick, I just want to applaud that because that was a very good Hell Breaks Loose. Also, for losing the heart on the very first shoot going down, that could put a lot of pressure on it in front of, 10 or 12 people in chat.
Completely deathless. You know. That was a flawless, full shoot after that. That was very good. All right, coming up on the final boss here, though, we're bringing back Gandalf. And
our boy.
Gandalf!
What'd you say there, Spike?
I said our boy.
Oh, all right. On my end, it cut out. I just heard ar.
That's actually usually what my commentary is. But go ahead, Kane. Okay.
All right, so we've got two different attacks here: the red attack and the blue attack.
Nice. Phase one's already over.
Very nice.
That was disgusting.
Yeah.
That is supposed to be a boss. Go ahead.
Using that red attack there to absolutely destroy the swarm, and then the red attack is just a more powerful attack that continues to flow through the whole enemy while the blue attack just impacts at a single spot. That's what's going on here. We got three phases.
Yeah, the second phase is just purely position-based. It's definitely the least amount going on. But there's two of them, one on each side. So he has to know when to switch over, make sure he's always dealing damage to it. There goes one. Now we must take out its brother. Two down, restarting sequence because you can actually buffer a jump in the sequence and gain a ton of height off of it. Bone wall boost right here.
Gets it.
Very nice, off the pig. This game has so much personality.
To the end. Whew. All right, let's see what he does here. There's some crazy strats for this final boss.
Yeah, so again, the red stuff is when you dash or hold the charge. That creates a big blast that goes through everything. Blue just impacts the front of it. However, waiting room, please.
Quick dashes just destroys the enemy.
It's the fastest way to make those charge punches happen. It's really good to do quick dashes. It's hard to explain what those are, but yeah.
He's got like a knuckles worth left.
There it is.
Time's coming up. We have got time coming up. We're setting up for one more co-op boost. Yo, can we get some 28-28s in the chat?
Once you do the final charge punch, that's time.
Yeah. So time will be in about 3, 2, 1, time.
Time.
I think you're a little delayed there, Spike, but yeah.
Yeah, somewhere in there, yeah. I'm going off of what my delay is.
Very nice. What was the final time?
Something.
Looks to be about
1:30:22.
Yeah. And by the way, Depressing has about like 10 minutes of loads. And we, for our RTA runs, we time out loads. So we got about 1:20 something.
And this also included that beginning cutscene and other stuff. But that was a very, very good run there.
Right, yeah.
So congrats to Depressing Child for putting on an awesome performance here.
Yeah, that was a really, really good run. Rayman Legends is booming right now. It genuinely is. There are routing differences going on at this moment. There's one Teens that's getting routed out and one getting routed back in. It's pretty crazy. So anybody who wants to get into this game, where would you go? Is there a Discord or anything?
Yeah, so if you're interested in running this game, you want to go to speedrun.com/Rayman_Legends. That'll take you to the main speedrunning page for this game. You'll see two links to two Discord servers there. You see the Rayman Legends Discord link, and you'll see the general Rayman Legends, the general Rayman speedrunning Discord link, which is for like all the Rayman games. If you're interested in running this game, be sure to join them both, and we will be helping you out if you request it. We'd be happy to help if you are just starting off running the game. It's a really cool game. I'd love to see new players run it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. It genuinely brings joy to my heart seeing this scene getting so active right now. And there's other categories. That's any percent. Preston Child, also the world record holder in all teensies, all 700 of them. So with that, though, we're a little bit behind schedule. We got a lot of runs coming up, including Eco, Ico, ICO. I don't even know. Bucci runs it, and there's a watermelon at some point. But only if you guys getting your donations right now. I agree with that from Kane, Nils, DJ, myself, Spike, and Depressing Child. Thank you all. And keep on donating. Have a good day.
See you guys later.
See you.
Awesome. And thank you, Depressing Child, for that run of Rayman Legends Any Percent. What a run, folks. And true to form, holy cow, do we have the donations coming in for the 28-28 hype. We have a $28.28 donation from 28. That was the name of the donor. Hoot, hoot. And we have a $28 donation from Chibi Scala. I'm probably screwing that name up. I apologize. Donation train. Let's get that watermelon ending in eco. And finally, here's a big one, folks. We have an anonymous donation for $2,828, $28.28 exactly. This run is amazing. Thank you for everyone for doing a great event for a great cause. Thank you so much for that anonymous donation. And thank you, everyone, for making the $28.28 real. Hype is happening. Take a look here, and we are at $3,870. We are so close to getting that eco ending, folks. Keep them coming in. The watermelon ending. We want to see this thing happen for real. We need your donations to make it happen. Keep them coming in. Agrarian Tycoon donates $29.74 and says, just can't handle these crazy invasion times. Putting this donation towards the watermelon ending. Thank you so much. Piper1618 donates $25 with the hashtag Wahoo! I'm so glad to see Eco make it into SGDQ. Good luck, Miucha. We're all cheering you on. Eco and Yorda deserve some refreshing watermelon after their adventure. So let's keep this donation. Let's keep that donation train going. Absolutely. In a bunch of awesome hype for the watermelon. Albert donates $100. Watermelon ending hype. You say watermelon so many times and it starts to twist the tongue a little bit. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to go to a quick Twitch ad. We'll be right back after this.
Hello, everybody. I am just about to finish up. My name is LattMackey, and you are watching Summer Games Done Quick Online 2020. Thank you all for being here. Hoping you're having a great time watching a great event for a great cause. We are getting close, folks. We may be really close. We are getting ever so close to the Eco Watermelon Ending incentive. There's still time. If you want to see this watermelon ending, and I got to tell you, I'd love to see it. So help us out and get in those donations right now, all going towards a great cause. Going to read a couple more here. There is a $25 donation from the W125. The watermelon ending wasn't even in the U.S. version of the game. It is critically important that everyone witness the watermelon ending. Absolutely. Thank you so much for the $25 donation. And we have a $25 anonymous donation. Love GDQ and all the positivity this community provides. Let's get Eco some delicious watermelon. We have a $25 donation from Space Turbulence that says, if 2020 has taught me anything, it's that doctors have enough to worry about without dealing with borders. Let's get those pesky borders out of their way so they can get their jobs done. Money goes to some delicious watermelons. Literally, all I want to do at this point now is eat watermelons after this is over. Oh, here's a good one. Sincenic donates $100. Greetings from Barcelona. Let's get that refreshing watermelon for poor Eco and Yorda. They will surely deserve it. It is so awesome to see all the watermelon hype. Folks, we're getting close. $4,451. We're forever so close. Keep it coming. $500 and we get to see some watermelon. Courtney 255 donates $50 and says, my boyfriend and I have been watching GDQ since we started dating 3 years ago. Today we are watching in our brand new home. Thank you guys for giving us our twice yearly serotonin fill. And as always, chat hype. Oh, we have another birthday one. This is exciting. Ikasama donates $25 and says, it's my birthday today. So what a gift that SGDQ also starts today. I'm looking forward to doing nothing but watching speedruns this week. Good luck to the runners and good wishes for the tech crew. And happy birthday to you, Ikasama. I have been told that we are about to queue over an interview. Thank you, everyone, for having me. I'm going to hand this off to Sam Without a Plan. Thank you all for being here. Keep the donation going. We are so close to that Eco Watermelon Ending incentive. Let's get it in there, and let's take it over for an interview right now.
Hey everybody, it's YellowKillerBee, and thank you for watching Summer Games Done Quick 2020. I am here with David TKI, and he is going to be running Shovel Knight, King of Cards, Any Percent. That run is coming up very soon, but we're going to have a chance to chat with him. So thank you so much for sitting down with me, David.
Hi, thank you so much for having me here.
Yeah, no problem. So we're actually going to get it started off. We have a lot of social media questions because people were really excited about this run. So first of all, Mr. M wants to know, why did you end up running Shovel Knight and not any other game, and what is so special about it? Well, of course, we know you do run other games, but why are you running Shovel Knight in this marathon?
There was a whole lot of stuff that came to me running this thing. I got back into speedrunning back in 2017, and I stuck to a couple of old favorites, but then that fall, I decided I wanted to jump into something new, and then I saw a Spectre of Torment tournament coming up, and so I jumped into that, and then I just loved it so much that I started learning all the other campaigns. So naturally, when King of Cards came out, I started running that a lot, and then I kept running it.
Well, and that's so great. I've heard so many stories of people who a tournament will get them into running a game, which is a great way to kind of get into the community and meet people. But you mentioned how this is a new campaign that is the last campaign that came out. So how is King of Cards different than the other campaigns?
Well, King Knight has his own way of controlling. His primary movement is just like a dash attack, and then, but his movement just stops, so you gotta figure out how to move through each room. And, well, sometimes that dash is hard to work with, because you gotta chain it into a roll, but if you chain it into a roll, then you might bounce off a wall, fall into a pit. So a lot of King is just optimizing that movement. There's a lot more movement than there are bosses. Most of the other Shovel Knight campaigns, you might spend a lot of time optimizing the bosses, but King Knight doesn't have very many bosses, so it's a lot more movement. But that said, don't blink on the boss fights, because they should be pretty good.
Well, yeah, and you had said that there was a couple really useful items that you get along the course of the run. Can you tell me a little bit more about those?
Sure. So we've got the heirloom upgrades, which cost vigor, basically King Knight's mana. The only one we're going to be picking up is the turncoat, and the turncoat is amazingly versatile. You basically shield like in Smash Bros., but if you get hit, then you charge up a counterattack and you can shoot it. But you can also roll while the shield is up, so that opens up a whole lot of options for you. Then after World 1, we pick up the Battery Brigandine armor, which allows you to charge your dash, and that's pretty useful on its own. But then when you combine the two, you get some interesting interactions.
So yeah, you had mentioned armor, and I do want to mention that we are having a bid war for the King Knight's colors. So if you care about what color the armor is, make sure to get your bids in for that. But we actually have another social media question. Dance Dad, also known as Wolfman2000, wants to know, of all the Shovel Knight campaigns, which one do you like the most? Of course, you are running King of Cards, but you've played the other ones. Do you have a favorite?
I think Spectre of Torment is way up there, but Shovel of Hope is pretty close. But yeah, I've spent more time with Spectre of Torment than any other campaign, so that's probably the clear favorite.
Nice. So I do want to talk to you, like, obviously this is a platformer, it has some great movement, but you are running another game in this marathon, which kind of, we were joking about this earlier, is a very, kind of a very different vein, but also very exciting. You are running Quest for Glory 1 on Friday, and so yeah, how is that, how are you going to switch gears to that, and how is that different than Shovel Knight?
So, first of all, Quest for Glory is kind of an older PC text parser adventure game, so as you might imagine, the gameplay overlap is not at all. But at some level, that actually makes it easier for me to switch, because there's no chance that I'm going to mix up my strategies for the game, so it's actually kind of easy to keep both practiced at a relatively good level.
Right, exactly. And you won't be, you know, getting confused as if you were running two of the same campaigns from the same game. Totally different control scheme. Go ahead.
Yeah, and I use a controller for Shovel Knight, but mm-hmm. I'm using keyboard and mouse for Quest with Lloyd.
And that also has a bid war on the characters. Is there a certain character you're hoping will win?
I'm most comfortable playing Quest for Glory as the fighter, but Seif would be a good second.
Nice. So one of the things that I noticed when I was watching the video, because you actually played this game at Corona Relief Dunkwick earlier this year, and you have a couple adorable kids who are often on the webcam with you. What do they think about you getting this game in the marathon?
I don't think they really understand. Okay, I did take the two kids to AGDQ earlier this year, mm-hmm. and then the four-year-old went back home pretty quick, but mm-hmm. the eight-year-old was with me all week, and he had a really good time, so I'm hoping to take them to more events.
Nice. It's always nice to see that up-and-coming generation of speedrunners being raised the right way. So we're almost out of time here, but I did want to ask you one more quick social media question. Quirky Squid wants to know, what's your favorite song from the entire Shovel Knight OST?
Flowers of Antimony from the original soundtrack. That's the Explodatorium level.
Nice. Well, there you have it. David TKI, thanks again for taking some time to chat with us. Everyone, you're going to want to stick around for the Shovel Knight King of Cards runs. That's coming up pretty soon. And also his other game, Quest for Glory, which is coming up on Friday. So thanks again, David.
Thank you so much for having me.
All right, everybody. Coming up next, we have Beauty, who is playing Aiko. So make sure to stick around for that. And with that, I'm going to throw it back to our hosting desk and Sam Without a Plan. Take it away, Sam.
I'm ready to see some speed runs on SGDQ 2020. Welcome, everyone, to SGDQ 2020. My name is Sam Without a Plan, and I'll be your host today for the upcoming Eco Run. Super excited to watch. But before then, let's get into some donations. We have a $200 donation from Spines Heath that says, excited to finally see Eco at GDQ. We also have a $250 donation from Twig that says, here's hoping for Yorta to be as uncooperative and rude as possible. Sorry, Biuchi. A $100 donation from Digital Zephyr that says, I am eating watermelon, only fair if Ego gets some too. $50 donation from H Disco. I don't want little Eco to get dehydrated. Get that kid some watermelon. And we definitely have, we've hit that watermelon ending. So get prepared to see that coming up soon.